Shall we go to Krishnapuram? Krishnapuram to meet Pandu. Pandu, the shopkeeper. What shop he was having? He was having a vegetable shop. So come, let's go to Krishnapuram. Krishnapuram, Pandu and his small vegetable shop. All people in his area used to come to Pandu to buy fresh and tasty vegetables. Business was going on nicely, but Pandu wanted to improve his business. So he was thinking of going to the next village, which is Ramapuram. And he had a friend there. His name is... What happened? Pandu's friend. I forgot his friend's name. Okay. We will have a name called Pindu. Okay. So Pandu and Pindu were friends. And Pindu had a very big business in Ramapuram. So now Pandu from Krishnapuram went to Ramapuram to buy a lot of this. What is this? This is coconut. Yes, you're right. He went to Ramapuram to buy coconuts. How many coconuts? So many. He took his bullock cart to Ramapuram and bought hundreds and hundreds of coconuts. He wanted to sell coconut also in his shop so that his business will improve. So he went there, loaded his bullock cart. You know bullock cart, isn't it? Maattu vandi. So that bullock cart full of coconuts, hundreds and 200 coconuts. The cart was full and he was very happy and he thanked his friend Pindu and he was returning to Krishnapuram. It was so much past lunchtime. It has crossed the midday and moving towards the evening. So Pandu wanted to reach home as soon as possible. So he drove the cart very fast, very fast, very fast. He made the bullocks to run so fast, so fast. So as he was going, a few yards later, one small boy came in the opposite direction. He stopped Pandu's cart and said, "Uncle, if you drive your cart this fast, you will reach home very, very late at night. If you go in the normal speed, you will reach home as early as possible." Saying that, the boy went. Now Pandu was thinking, he said, "What logic is this? If we drive the cart fast, we should reach fast, no? But why is this boy saying opposite? How is it possible?" Thinking that, he did not mind the boy's words. He drove the cart fast, fast, fast. Then only he realized, as soon as the cart went very fast, all the coconuts from the cart started falling. Chop, 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 chop. One after the other, one after the other, one after the other. Then Pandu had to stop the cart, jump from the cart, run around, pick up all the coconuts from here, from here, from here, collect everything and put again in the cart. Then he will drive fast, fast, fast. Again, what will happen? All the coconuts will fall, top, 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 top. Then again, Pandu will stop the cart, jump, run around here and there, pick up, pick up, pick up all the coconuts he picked up. put it in the cart and then drive the cart again. By this way, it was more than the time fixed to reach his home. As the boy told, he reached home in the midnight. Had he had driven the cart slowly, no coconut would have fallen down. All the time, he would have saved and he would have reached the home correctly. No. So, after reaching the home only, he understood. Oh, why the boy said like that? If you drive fast, you will reach home late. I did not understand that time. Only now, I understand. Ah, my hands are paining. Ah, my back is paining. How many times I jumped from the cart to collect the coconut. Best I have to go now, take a shower and eat properly and sleep. Now, after this, I have to think correctly, wisely and then only act. Saying this, Pandu went, had nice shower, had good food and slept off immediately. So the coconuts reached very late, but it gave a good, wise advice and realization to Pandu. Okay, you all take care. We'll meet tomorrow again with another story. Till then, bye-bye.